What's up, everybody? Quick video here about the basics of breathing. So I have my rib cage model here. Let's get everybody acquainted. So this is me looking at you with the rib cage. So you can actually just put it right here. It's obviously smaller. The back is going to be the spine. These are the ribs that come among us. Remember, at the bottom of your rib cage, below that is going to be your lumbar spine, where people think of their lower back. So those bottom ribs are extremely important, and they're often pushed forward, but we'll get into that. The first thing that we're going to talk about is this infrasternal angle. So this is just the angle right here. In class, I talk about the Iron Man symbol all the time. So you think about where Iron Man gets his power from, that light right here. That's where I'm talking about your sternum. I just say it's an Iron Man symbol because it's very easy. And we want to be able to think about moving it, rotating, because that's our ribs really rotating. The next point about the infrasternal angle is these ribs actually internally rotate and externally rotate. So it's a very dynamic part of our body, meaning your infrasternal angle could be wide, or it can be narrow. So wide is going to be kind of like, think about a power lifter, very wide, quite literally, you can usually tell. And then narrow is going to be, maybe think about like a ballerina dancer who's very long but very narrow. These are just shapes. Now, what these shapes do is they do change with every single breath. So that's something to really consider. What we want to do is not have the perfect shape, but more so just be able to be dynamic. Meaning when you inhale, these shapes can change, this angle can change. We can expand laterally, we can expand backwards. And then when we exhale, probably the most important thing that I want to get across in this video is we're able to actually close the front door, which is a huge part of everything we do. And being able to close the front door is exactly this. It's an internal rotation of those lower ribs. Our lower ribs are malleable, or they're able to really change even in structure over time. Your whole body really is, from a cellular level, but even more so these lower ribs. Now, what we want to think about is when we fully exhale, you're going to actually internally rotate with these ribs and close the front door like we talked about. Now, when we have the ability to do this, we stop taking belly breaths where we just fill up just the bottom, and we actually get air into our lungs, which is going to be up and under our rib cage. So when the lungs actually expand, they push and fill up all the way up under our collarbones. They fill up outwards, laterally, and very, very important, they fill up the back ribs. So these individual ribs, our upper back, the turtle shell is what we call it in class, often will actually get filled up. The only way to get air up into the back, the sides, and all these great places is if you've learned how to fully exhale. That's why during class we do so many things that focus on fully exhaling and then pausing and staying there. Being able to fully exhale and get into this position of your rib cage and just sit here for a second, relax, and then take a nice relaxed inhale gives us the ability to get those lungs to fill up, the air to push out 360 degrees in every direction, and eventually creep into the top. So let's talk about some bad habits that we talk with breathing. The first one is going to be deadlifting your rib cage, or essentially using your neck to pull air in. If you can imagine that these muscles in my neck actually have tissue that runs into all the tissue that's going to come across the ribs and connect into the ribs and move the ribs, if I take a bad breath like this, I'm essentially pulling my ribs up. And it's not a coincidence that if you do that 20,000 or even 100 times a day, that you kind of feel tension in your neck. Some of you might even see that you have lines, veins, and things going on in your neck. That is not what we want. And that's why we created a class called the Neck Tranquilizer. So that's something that you would check out. Now, what we don't want to get confused with is the idea that that means you shouldn't breathe into your chest. Because the chest is actually the last stop of filling up 360 degrees. We always breathe from the bottom. Our diaphragm is a muscle that is right here under the rib cage. When we inhale, it pulls down to draw air in. So when that pulls down and brings the air into the rib cage, it starts from the bottom and fills all the way up to the top as more air comes in. So a really quality full inhale is actually not going to be a deep breath as much as it's going to be a 360 degree breath filling all the way up to the top. We do want these ribs to move. So it's not that they're not going to move. It's not that your chest isn't going to expand. It's that it's going to be the last thing to expand, or everything kind of expands at once, even more so bottom to the top, but at once is okay as well. Now, if we want to expand the chest, one of the things we need to learn is the difference between the side ribs and the front. The front are going to work more in a pump handle. So think you're at the gas station and you're taking that pump, pulling it back and putting your gas in. So this part right here will actually lift up like that. So when air gets in here, it lifts it up like this. There's a big difference between this lifting up and me arching my lower back. So you can easily fake that motion at the rib. The ribs on the side are going to be more of what we would call a bucket handle. You think the handle's here and it pulls up to the side and then I go carry my bucket on with me. So these ribs are almost like Lamborghini doors that are going to open out to the side when they expand. So when we do lateral breathing, we try to keep this down relatively, even though again it's dynamic, it's going to change. And then we talk about getting these ribs to move away from each other and expand as if your fingers are the ribs and they're gonna slowly come away from each other and they're gonna expand outward. So different parts of your ribs fill up different ways. Now, when we're trying to get that, it all depends on how well we exhale, which is why you hear me say the exhale is the alley-oop to the inhale. A full exhale with a pause is the best way to get a good inhale. So we do want your chest to expand. We do want your back ribs to expand. We want everything to expand. We even want your belly to expand to a certain point. And we want to be able to keep some relative tension with your obliques that run across here, your TVA, your six pack runs down here. And we want all of those muscles to work well at being able to close and open the rib cage, closing on exhales, opening on inhales, and getting air into every single spot in your rib cage. So that's a good intro for the basics of breathing. Let us know if you have any questions about that, and we'll answer everything you got.